All right. If you didn't know what I was doing last time, I'm on Roblox and I'm playing all three Back to the Futures. This is a game you can play on Roblox. The year 2015. Nice. Fly the DeLorean down to the highway exit. You know what? Do I really need to fly it down to the highway exit? What's the train doing here? This is funny. Every time when I go to the future, the train's here. But the train doesn't come until part three. So what's the train doing here? It's not like Duck goes to the future at the end of part three. He said he already been there. This is so weird. Oh, shoot. Okay, I fell down, but yeah, I'm in now 2015. And now I have to go find the DeLorean and go back to 1985, I guess. Well, the DeLorean is stuck up there, but I'm okay because I have something I want to see really quick before I kill myself and go back to the time machine. Every time when I bring the time machine down, it takes me to the next present.
Time machine? Yep.
The time machine.
Dumb game.
What? This is not the dumb one.
Watch this!
Idiot.
What?
Nothing.
Is that the dumb one?
Okay, wait.
Game you like?
One of the ones. Yes. I'm playing the Pro Back to the Future game. I already played it. I'm just recording myself playing it now, so. Okay, where the heck is that almanac? In 2015. It's in here, guys. I promise. We're not going to do the whole storyboard. But I just want to grab the almanac. Oh, here it is. This is where Griff is, and there's the almanac. I'm going to grab it. Normally, I would talk to Duck, then go to Griff, talk to Duck, and then go to who knows where. But I'm not going to do the... I'm not going to play the Back to the Future movies. I'm just going to go to all the timelines from Part 1, 2, and 3. So if you don't know what I was doing, this is called the storyboard of Back to the Future. If you're tired of watching the trilogy of Back to the Future, why not just, instead of watching the trilogy, you live the trilogy. That's what this is. It doesn't look like it is, but what usually happens is that you try to... So first, you know how I started out in the garage? First, you go to the question mark that's by the telephone, which Duck calls, and then... He tells you to meet you in the mall. It doesn't go exactly by the movies. It skips a few scenes, and it took me 3 hours to do the whole entire trilogy. It would take me 6 hours to actually watch it, so it doesn't do every single plot twist and plot line. Yeah, but like it's similar to the original movies. It's the same thing. They just skip details to make the story go faster, so you're not on Roblox for 6 hours. So anyway, each Back to the Future is about an hour long. The reason why they're not an hour on here is because I'm not actually playing the storyline. I'm just walking around and then jumping from time machine to time machine, showing you all the timelines. I wish I can give you a great view of what each time period looks like, but I just want you to get the feel of being in Back to the Future. Well, I'm the one getting the feeling because I'm the one playing this, but you're not. And as you see, I'm not Marty, of course, but I'm acting as if I was Marty. And since I have a girl Roblox account, that makes me a girl Marty, who's gay, who has a gay relationship with Jennifer Parker, I guess. All right, I'm gonna kill myself now. So I can get back to the time machine because it's up in the sky, and I just jumped down. I meant to do that. I could drive the time machine down, but every time when I drive it, it just takes me to the future. I mean, I try really hard not to decelerate to 88, but every time when I hit the ground, it suddenly goes up to 88, and then I didn't want to leave yet. Now I do want to leave, so I don't know if I want to go down, though, because, anyway, first time I played this, I went up. Last time when I tried to bring the time machine down, I actually just went to the future. That's okay. We're going to go to 1985. Do 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 do. Got it. Okay. Now we have to go from 1985. Gotta get back in time. Okay, get out, run. Got it. You know, this is where he goes into his house and it's not really his. You know, it's an alternate timeline. Well, that was fast. Look, look, look. They turned the clock tower into Biff's cannon museum. The time machine is on the top, so all we have to do is go up Biff's building and that's it. There's other conversations, of course, and like I said, if I was doing the actual storyline, I could definitely spend hours making these videos and playing Back to the Future, but I'm not going to do that. That would take forever. I already played it for 3 hours, and so now if I'm going to record myself playing it, I'm just going to skip right to the chase. I'm not going to go for the movie type. I'm just going to take you to all the timelines. So like that conversation with Biff in the office, I was going to do that, but I'm not going to. That's, you know, you should go to Roblox and play this. It's the greatest Back to the Future game. It's the only one you can actually find. On Roblox. The other games are pretty much noob games, you know? Copyright noob games. However, I had to jump to this one. You'll see in a minute. However, there is one noob game where it's Hill Valley and you don't get to do anything, but you have the time machines from all three Back to the Futures. Each Back to the Future has a different kind of DeLorean. Maybe I'll show, since I hate on numbers and there's not a part four, I'll have to show you that in my last video. It won't be in this game, it will be in a different game on Roblox, but out of all the noob games on Roblox, there's only one that I like and it has the collection of all the Back to the Futures. This one's the only pro game, so it's okay. They wanted to celebrate the 35th anniversary, so this just barely came out along with that noob game as well, but there's other noob games that existed before, and Back to the Future wasn't a thing on Roblox until today. Unless you wanted to play those noob games that weren't really Back to the Future. You could time travel in the DeLorean, but you wouldn't actually time travel. And like the noob game where I collect all the Back to the Future cards, you can't time travel in that either. When I say pro game, you can actually time travel in these DeLoreans. When I say noob games, you don't time travel in them. It's just a waste of game. But anyway, this is the only pro game they have on Roblox. Then the only noob game that I like is the one where you can collect all three cars. The other ones just have one car from part one. It's just boring. You just drive around. The only thing that interests me is the one that collects all three cars. We'll get to that noob game after we finish this one. Ugh. No! No! Okay, go back up. Now drive it. Oh, phew. Okay, now we're going to go to 1955. Sorry, there is ground. It's just floating. All right. Gotta get back in time. Back in 1955, we have two ducks, two Martys. One duck is trying to get the part one Marty back to the future, while the other duck is, you know, trying to get the almanac from Biff. Okay, since we're back in 1955, like I said in part one, you'll get to see Marty's school, because that's where the time machine is that will take us to part three. The time machine won't time travel. The time machine that's on top of this high school building, different. Look, as a scene from Back to the Future, Marty's playing the band. And in one of the scenes, I will have to come back here and stop people from trying to antagonize Marty. Because if he doesn't get Back to the Future, then we'll have a major paradox, right? But since I'm not playing the actual movie, we're not going to do that. Like I said, you could play the actual movie on Roblox, but we're not going to do that. I'm just going to go straight to the future. I mean, I'm going to go straight to the next timeline. So, and like I said, there's one more conversation that happens over here where Biff steals the almanac and gets in his car and I have to go after him. But we're not going to play that scene because I want to just go to the next timeline. So unlike Back to the Future Part 1, 2, and 3, you have to, well, unless you fast forward, you have to watch the whole thing all the way through. Unless you go to scene selection or fast forward. But on here, you can skip parts without even touching the remote. Except you need to use the arrows to move around, obviously. Especially when you play the movie. See, the reason why my girl account, the reason why I'm able to walk around is that I'm using the arrows on my D-pad. On my computer. Okay. I also walk fast on here. In the first 1955, I walked slow, but this one I walked faster, so that's cool. I would show you Duck's house and Biff's house, but fortunately, sorry. We're just gonna get straight to the case. Besides, my camera can't handle an hour-long video. So, if this recording's gonna work, we have to end it soon. So, I'm just trying to get through each part as fast as I can. Okay. I can listen to Johnny Be Good, but I don't know if I want to stay for the whole song, because I don't want the video to end. Shoot. Can't get in.
All right. This is an oldie, but well, it's an oldie right. Where I come from. All right, guys, listen, this is a blues riff.
Sorry, I know you like I know you like Marty's Big Number, but I'm not gonna stay for it because I don't want the recording to be too long. Usually at the end it plays the overture to Back to the Future, and then it does that whole scene all over again, but we're not going to do that. All right, Dr. Scott struck by lightning. Check. And, you know, they have to burn the almanac, which is over here. Check, check. And then it tells us to go behind this truck, which is not here yet. So I'll go behind the sign first and then go to the truck. All right. This is where part two almost ends. Okay, so Duck is struck by lightning. Now we go behind the truck without reading everything. You can if you want to. Pause the video if I'm too fast. Alright, now we go behind the truck. Sometimes you have to go to certain places in order for it to work. But when you can just skip things, that makes it faster. Luckily, you don't actually have to read the conversations if you ever have to listen to one in order to get to the next scene or the next part. Okay. Now, here's the end of part two. End of part two, right here. Oh yeah. This is where I talk to Duck. I'm not gonna click on his dollar bill sign. Instead of trying to read it to you, I'm just gonna tell you straight out. So when I click on this dollar sign, it basically just says, here, look, I'll just click on it. You know, just to let you know what this is. Oh, I need to get closer to him. Okay. See, he says it works. It really works. And then Marty runs around the corner and says, "You sent back. You know, I'm back. I'm back from the future." No, you can't be. I just sent you back to the future. But I'm back. I'm back from the future. And then Duck says, "Great Scott!" Faints, and then he tells me to go. So that's what it looks like when you have a conversation with someone. But I'm not going to keep pushing these, you know? I'm just going to tell you what they say so that the video can be faster. So anyway, there's the part one Marty going to the future, and then I'm part two Marty about to start part three. So without further ado, I'll see you in part three. Okay. We're going to end the video right after the music ends. Nope, we don't have time to wait for that. All right. Have a good day, guys.